Previously on Kitchen Nightmares, Chef Ramsay was back in Southern California.
Holy crap.
But it was far from a day at the beach.
What you're doing is so wrong.
No.
Zaina Flaming Grill may have been a dream of Faye and her partner in East, Brenda.
It's rock and roll.
But this Mediterranean restaurant in Redondo Beach has become a true nightmare.
When I put this meat somewhere in the grill, do not move it.
Right from the beginning, this partnership was troubled with many issues.
It's done.
Yeah, it was on that side.
It's on.
Faye claims that not only will the restaurant not function without her.
I can fight by myself.
What? But that she is the only one putting in a real effort.
I just want more help.
Brenda claims Faye is a martyr.
You don't let anybody help you.
Not willing to let anyone help.
You've not been shown the recipes?
No.
And that is why she has given up.
I'm gonna go sit down in my booth.
Both owners did agree that their food was excellent.
Chef Ramsay is no way he would dislike my food.
But it didn't take long for Chef Ramsay to realize that it was anything but.
Looks like someone's puked up on my plate.
Oh, come on.
When Gordon gave them a wake-up call on the food,
all you're doing is damaging your business.
I need help.
Faye refused to take any of the blame.
So who's not pulling their weight?
None of them.
That's not true.
Which led to the staff playing the blame game.
If you want to start pointing fingers, Brenda, after you swept, it's been dirty.
Server Amel pointed out Faye's stubbornness.
I've offered to cut chicken multiple times, and I was told that I wasn't allowed to do it. I offered.
She never did.
And Faye disagreed wholeheartedly.
That's not true.
At dinner service,
all that chicken is done.
The fighting in the kitchen continued.
Brenda, put more chili. That's why I cut these jalapenos. Use them.
Whatever.
And customers were disappointed with what they were receiving.
That's disgusting.
Including a Mediterranean staple, the hummus.
My apologies.
Chef Ramsay set out to prove how substandard their food really is.
Ladies, there we are, some fresh hummus.
By giving customers store-bought hummus.
That's good.
Much better.
Which temporarily pleased many of the diners.
Yeah.
But unfortunately,
the chicken was just nasty.
The hummus was just one of many problems.
Oh, no.
She said she didn't like it at all.
When Chef Ramsay did an investigation, he uncovered terrible practices in the refrigerator and freezer.
That's all freezer burnt.
He also found countless containers filled with frozen food.
Can I show you something? Just two
sure.
When it was time to confront Faye.
Get real.
I am.
No, you're not.
At first, she remained in denial.
No.
Then suddenly,
I feel like I'm hanging by a thread.
She realized how deep a hole she has dug for herself.
I've been praying and saying tomorrow would be a better day.
Now, with Faye completely overwhelmed,
that better day is not coming.
Chef Ramsay has serious doubts about whether a turnaround is even possible.
I'm done.
Tonight.
This is crazy.
It's the explosive conclusion of Zaina Flaming Grill.
I even told you write down what I tell
you. One time, are you kidding me?
The fighting actually escalates.
Nobody wants to help her because she's so critical.
And no one is backing down.
Go, go.
Don't talk to me like that.
Chef Ramsay is stuck in the middle of a seemingly hopeless restaurant.
Faye.
She won't change, and there's no question about it.
Will he be able to help Faye and Brenda resolve their differences?
Faye has shut down.
Or will one of them,
you,
be forced to leave the business?
I'm going home.
What is that? You're serving rotten food.
They're not crap, and they're delicious.
Then wake up! You wake up! Shut the place down!
Get out of here!
Thank you so much.
I don't think you understand how far you've slipped. Get real.
I am.
No, you're not. Why aren't your customers coming back to your restaurants, Faye?
I don't know. Tonight was a shock to me. Like, wow, why everything is coming back? There is certain plates I'm very proud of, and it came back.
But it's not good enough. What you're doing is so wrong. Flaming grill, it's not. Extinguished grill, it is. And the problems, Faye, are inside. Do you want this business to continue?
I feel like I'm hanging by a thread. There's no point in running this. Praying and saying tomorrow would be a better day. That better day is not coming. I'm done. nothing else. I never thought it would be such a failure. I never seen it in that way, never.
I can see the sadness.
I'm so sorry. I'm just overwhelmed.
No, please don't be overwhelmed, but just answer this for me. Do you want to continue?
I do. This is all I have. I'm just burned out. I overwork.
No, but are you 100% sure that you want to continue in this business?
I do. I love what I do. Tonight it didn't show because I really didn't love the way things were going.
Okay. I'm getting out of here. I want you to change your attitude. Because if you can't change what you're doing, we have no chance in trying to change this restaurant.
Yes.
I hope to see you tomorrow.
Thank you, sir. I honestly have nothing left if I lose here. This is it. This is my life. And if it doesn't work, I don't know what to do.
You got 2 seconds?
Yeah, that was rough. And I'm gonna call it as I see it. You guys are just going through the motions. And when something goes wrong, you fall out with your auntie, she falls out with you, and all of a sudden, you then just go back into your own corners, and the only people suffering are the customers. All night long, the problems are on the outside. The problems are the customers. It's never inside, and we never ever look objectively and understand how bad we are. Everyone's walking around in denial.
It was hard to hear. I'm not upset because I'm in denial. I'm just upset because this is the first time we've encountered this.
Not trying to rub your face in it.
Right.
But tonight, three tables started complaining about the hummus. I ran 100 meters up the road. I store-bought it. Came back through the kitchen, presented it. They loved it. I'm trying to get that message through to your aunt. But when customers think that a store-bought hummus is better than what you've just served them and charged them three times the money, that's how far we've slipped. And you know what? It's sad in there. It is so sad. I've got a question for you. Deep down inside, from the bottom of your heart, do you want to seriously continue running this business?
I definitely do.
Do you?
Yes, I do.
100%. Okay. I'll see you in the morning.
Okay.
Good night.
Good night.
I need a hug. You're okay? Everything for the best.
No, don't cry.
We need to make it better. He's right when it comes to certain points. It's just I need you to help me here.
Instead of pointing the finger, can we come up with a list of things that you could do to improve?
I think that's actually a really great idea.
I actually want to go. I'm really tired. I'm frustrated.
In Faye's mind, she thinks that we're the problem and that we make mistakes and that we're the issue. But she's the chef, she's the prep, she does everything. And I believe 100% that she won't change, and there's no question about it.
Okay, everybody clock out and go home.
I'd love to fix all these problems, but my hands are tied. Fame has to trust me as a business partner in order for things to change.
Coming up.
This is crazy.
The fighting intensifies.
Did you ever ask me?
No, but I've come and asked help. When you I've asked.
As the staff reaches a breaking point.
She's this.
Are you kidding me?
Wow.
And Faye continues to hold her ground.
I even told you bring a damn piece of paper and a pen and write down what I tell
you. One time, 2 days ago.
Stop.
And later.
No, you have a
mouth on you. That's unbelievable.
Chef Ramsay makes a drastic decision.
You are going home.
Chef Ramsay knows the only way he can move forward with fixing the restaurant,
let's come out over here,
is that he first must find a way to get Brenda and Faye on the same page. He begins the day with a staff meeting with the goal of clearing the air.
Last night, I saw you, Faye, burnt out, feeling alone, isolated, and you saw no light at the end of the tunnel. I understand after you telling me how hard it is and you're on your own. I get all that. I got that yesterday. But last night, I watched everything. And you work, talk, and perform like someone has given up. Last night, I went into the kitchen and just took a few notes. There must be 3 to 4 weeks' worth of prep, frozen solid in there.
All freezer burnt. It's supposed to be beef, sure.
Do you know, in that freezer, there's containers stacked this high full of prep. You've prepped so far in advance, it's freezer burnt. Then I look at the refrigeration unit in there, and it is bedlam. The fresh stuff is at the front, and the old stuff is at the back.
I honestly don't have all the stuff there.
You don't? Oh, this is so difficult. I'm not going to embarrass you and bring out the yellow and the rotten parsley.
OK.
So you know what's in the back of the fridge?
Yes.
What I want to talk about this morning is why is it like that?
Lack of help, lack of...
You're freezing it for the lack of help.
Yes.
Faye, before I can go any further forward, let me ask you this. Do you think that you're the only one that's actually working and prepping in this restaurant?
Yes. They can call me a liar if they want to. They come here, do their shift. I feel like they're here to make their tips and leave.
Right.
That's my honest truth.
Yeah, well...
That's how I feel about them.
So who was the first person that literally gave up? Your son? Your niece.
Brenda.
Brenda? Is that true? You sit there in silence.
I sit here in silence because I know the truth. I know that I've stepped up so many times. I do.
But she has other people who offer to do it. I try to help, but...
I don't like Amal to be in the kitchen because she cries about everything and little thing, and she all day. All day.
No.
Yes, she did burn herself with
Once.
Hot water, booked herself with knife, even...
I haven't poked myself with a knife.
And she's denying this right now because she doesn't... Let me finish. I feel responsible for her asking for bandage all the time, and I don't want blood in the food. I don't want the drama itself. Amal complains about being here after 9 o'clock. She gave me an attitude face.
It was 10:30.
But it was her time to go out with her boyfriend waiting for her outside. She's this. Only talk, not do.
Right.
And when I say that to her, she take it as a mean. I'm the biggest bee that she ever seen.
Do you trust her?
I do. She's amazing help.
She just
She's
said
a very
she does
good
it.
Worker.
I'm confused. I trust her, but I don't trust her. Does she not welcome help?
Oh, not for me whatsoever.
I think when she's drained, she accepts the help, but she has to reach that level.
Can I say why I do that?
Go ahead.
I hear complaint from Brenda all the time because she wants off. She needs her time
That's
off.
That's not what Brenda's saying. Look at Brenda.
Hey. I tell you, when I have a family event to go to and I slip out of here for an extra day, I feel guilty.
I know.
And
you
I've
said
expressed that to you so many times. I feel guilty.
What I tell you
I don't
why.
Like taking time
I tell
off.
You why.
And it's because
I tell you why, and I wanted you to have fun and enjoy family when you're out of here.
Exactly.
So you don't come with that burden and that look again. Like you don't want to be here.
And I don't want you to have that same look either, Faye.
I didn't have that look the reason.
How many no? How many times have I told
and
you?
I am the one who have to carry everything.
Faye, wait a minute.
Every
How many
three.
Times have I asked you, please take an extra time off?
I
go
tell you,
home
can you
for
be
a few
able
days.
To do things when I'm not here?
And I do. I do anything that you ask me to do. You tell me to roast
ask.
The eggplant and peel it, I
ask.
Do.
Because unless I ask you to please let me do something, let me help you out, unless I do, you don't tell me, hey, come back here and help me.
I make a list.
How many
and
times?
And I leave it 90% of the time. I end up with no
breakfast. 99% of the
when
stuff
When I have
is done.
Lunch and I have to serve.
No, 99% of the time is done. And if it's not done, it's because I was busy on the line. That's the only time stuff doesn't get done. I've many times walked in the back. She's like, I have a lot of preparation. What can I help with? I'll put freaking gloves on and I'll pull out a cutting board and a knife. Tell me how to do it. Show me how to do
Until
it.
Until we get a phone call and we leave the kitchen, never come back.
I'm so confused.
But I am.
I go through the same stuff you do. I mean, I'm not sitting here freaking leg over leg doing nothing.
So why does Faye have to prep for you when it's her day off?
Because she feels that she needs to season things, that she needs to cut things, and it has to be
Why
done
though?
By
You're cooking
her.
Them. You're cooking them. It's like you can't trust your family. Who can you trust?
It's not a point of trust. It's a point of everyone, they want their time off.
So they don't want to be here as much as you do?
It's
Even
not...
your 50% partner?
Yes.
Wow.
That's not
wow.
true. That is so not true.
That's true.
Maybe everybody's assuming that I don't want to be here, or she doesn't want to be here, or nobody wants to be here. It's not voiced.
Right.
Nothing's voiced. There's poor communication.
I can see that. This is crazy.
Any of you showed up an hour earlier just to get your own thing going?
I show up early a lot, actually.
I have your time card.
Okay, you have my time card, then you know I'm at least 10 to 20 minutes early.
You're never here 20, 30, 40, 1 hour earlier.
Because I don't need to be here an hour early because I need to take care of my dining room. That is the job that you have given me, so I do.
Did you hear that? She took care of the dining room, which looks like this all the time.
Why do you feel so uncomfortable that the night before you take your day off, you have to control them? With everything that you do, why has it got that bad?
Nobody stepped in.
Brenda's offered, everybody's offered,
and she won't teach anybody because she wants to do it. When she complains and stuff like that, she doesn't allow
That's
anybody to do anything.
I even told you, bring a damn piece of paper and a pen and write down what I tell
One
you.
One time, 2 days ago, 3 days ago. Are you kidding me?
Don't ever use that word with me, ever. I mean it, do not ever. Use this language with me.
It's all about my language, but you're not listening to what I'm trying to say behind
it. No, I'm trying. For the last 4, 5, 7 years you were here, did you ever ask me to come and write things down?
No, but I've come and asked for help in the kitchen.
Enough.
You can ask her.
When you ask, I told you to come and bring a piece of paper and pen and write exactly what I'm doing.
You told me that 3 days ago when we were making
but
statements.
It
that was
the only
time you've ever said anything
but
like that.
That was the only time, and
whatever.
I told you do not use that language
whatever.
With me for the second time.
Whatever. I've offered so many times.
You've been here for years. If you were so smart, why you didn't come next to me one day and said, you know what?
I did. I stayed in the kitchen and watched you cut meat, and you tell me to shut up and get out.
No, that's not true. That's a lie.
What started out as a staff meeting to clear the air...
I go through the same stuff you do!
...has erupted into a screaming match between Faye and the staff.
I even told you bring a damn piece of paper and a pen and write down what I tell
you! One time! 2 days ago! Are you kidding me?
With Faye holding on to her belief that no one is committed.
So they don't want to be here as much as you do?
Yes.
Wow.
And the staff holding on to their belief...
Nobody wants to help her because she's so critical of the way you do help her!
...that Faye is actually unwilling to accept help from anyone.
Okay, stop.
Don't you want to be consistent?
Yeah, of course, yeah, naturally. But what is it that you struggle with to teach them?
I tried.
No, I don't think you're trying enough.
She doesn't have the patience to train somebody. If she does, she'll show you and then she'll say, do it. And then if you do it and it's not perfect the way she wants, she'll get so frustrated and she'll yell at you to the point where it's just,
okay.
You feel overwhelmed yourself. And
did I ever do that with you?
Yes.
That's not true.
Mom, is that true?
She has a hard time trusting people.
Faye told me yesterday, if you were not family, 1, 2, 3, 4 of you would be fired. Now.
Yes.
Why can't you trust them to run this business?
I can.
You can.
Prove it. No, you need to prove that you have the trust.
Okay. I'm gonna agree to something. I'm gonna leave everything not done the night before.
Not
and
done.
You walk here and you ask to be served food and see what you're gonna get.
Stop there. Do you know what? We're gonna open for lunch. I'd like to see you and you behind the line. I'd like to see you and you in the dining room. And you are going home.
Okay.
Okay, and I will give you feedback on how it went. You've got 15 minutes. Let's go, 15 minutes. You happy with that?
Yes.
Let's go.
I know I could do this without Faye, and I would love for her to see that I am capable of doing this and I can run the show.
It's your time to shine.
You okay?
I'm okay.
You sure?
Yes.
This is hard for you.
Very.
Yeah?
Today is gonna be a disaster. I don't feel like it goes the way it's supposed to go when I'm not here.
Now, I want you to jump in here. Yeah?
They're gonna struggle without me.
I have a confession for you. You're not going home, really. I'd like you to sit in here and watch carefully. Because I don't think you really know what goes on in your restaurant when you're not there.
Okay.
Listen carefully.
I will.
Pay close attention to everything you see.
Okay.
Okay, good.
Thank you, sir.
I'll see you later.
Thank you so much.
All right.
All right.
Amel or Vanessa, does someone know how to put the rice cooker on cook?
No.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
wow, Mark.
Brenda, this is cooking, right?
No. I'm holding my breath for them.
Got customers coming in, guys.
Hello.
Oh, welcome to Zana Flaming Grill.
Go ahead and have a seat.
I'll with you. And what can I get for you, sir?
I'll do the lamb kebab, please.
I'm going to try the beef shawarma sandwich.
Can we try the tabo?
The tabo?
Yeah.
Sure.
First order on.
Yeah.
What is it?
A metabol appetizer.
Okay.
If you can get the sides for me, Mark.
You got it.
The first orders are in.
How are we doing on the meats, Mark?
Beef is done. Kofta's done.
Excellent.
One piece of lamb should be coming out any minute.
And without phase micromanagement.
Are those potatoes ready? It needs to go
yep,
out with
potatoes ready.
All right.
Brenda, working alongside Mark, seems to have the kitchen under control.
This is ready. Table two.
Here we go. We have your falafel.
Beef shawarma sandwich with onion.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And the lunch service is off to a solid start.
I need chicken shawarma started.
Turn around and check Brenda because there is shawarma sitting there for a while.
Mark, let me know what's ready so we can start dishing.
Chicken's almost ready. Beef shawarma's almost ready. The beef, maybe two more minutes before the beef shawarma.
You have a whole pan that's cooked already. Come on, you guys. Use the cooked one.
This chicken is done.
Make sure that shawarma have no oil in it when you dish it.
A little bit more.
Oh, my God.
Go.
Table five.
Shawarma supposed to be oily, sorry.
No. It just seems like everything in here is over oiled.
Do you want me to just take it?
Please.
Okay, sure.
It's a bit of oil.
It just seemed a little bit over
oiled. Oil, no, down, sorry.
Table five does want the kebabs, but they don't want to wait 20 minutes for it.
It's going to be a 10-minute wait.
Okay, I'll tell them.
As the busy lunch service continues without Faye...
Okay, we're getting backed up.
Pressure in the kitchen is clearly mounting.
Make sure your customers are happy, guys.
No, Mark, you don't have to say things like that.
Faye's son, Mark, and outspoken server, Amel...
I
need to make flaming potatoes. Move that.
...are beginning to butt heads.
Go do something else. Don't worry about 2 seconds. I'll get it done for you when it's ready.
We heard you. Thank you. We hear you. Thank you.
No, you have a mouth on you that's unbelievable.
Hey, Mark, watch your mouth. Relax.
Emma, so I can't...
Shut up.
Mark.
Go.
Watch
go.
It. Don't talk to me like that.
Come on, you guys.
Go.
Without the staff's knowledge, Chef Ramsay is attempting to show Faye that the restaurant can run without her.
I don't think you really know what goes on in your restaurant when you're not there.
He has set up a stakeout vehicle for her to observe.
Now you have a mouth on you that's unbelievable.
Oh my God.
And although Brenda seems to have a firm grip on running the kitchen.
Are those potatoes ready? It needs to go
yep,
out with this order.
Ready.
All right.
Mark and Amel have started to bicker at each other.
Mark,
go.
Watch
go.
It. Don't talk to
me
like that.
Come on, you guys.
You okay?
Yes.
I swear to God, I'm gonna shove my foot straight up his Mark.
Sarcasm needs to stop.
Well,
it's called communication.
Brenda's getting straight to the point with her mail.
This is really hard for me.
Why is it hard?
Because I put more dedication and more love into this, and Martha's going to yell at me and tell me what
to do. He's not yelling at you.
Are you kidding? I had parsley in my hand. I was sprinkling on. I told him I was going to take it.
Stop for a second.
Amal gets very frustrated when someone trying to correct her.
No, no, but look at the way Brenda's controlling the situation.
When Martha says that to us,
can you stop and listen to me?
When something sits on the counter,
it needs to go out quickly.
See, Brenda can do it. Look how tough.
He asked you what table so it can go out hot and fresh.
That's Brenda showing that she's capable of being a boss.
Yes.
To help you.
Brenda seems to be in charge now. I'm proud of her.
Do you want to continue to argue?
No, she will get this done.
All right, I'm going to start dishing. Mark, let me know what's ready so we can start dishing.
It's almost ready. Beef shawarma's almost ready. Start dishing, Brenda.
Table 5. Ready?
So I have your order all set.
Good job.
Good job, guys.
You ready? We'll have a little fun with them now, okay?
Sure.
Then you can tell them how proud they are. Last table gone?
Yes.
Yeah, good. Come over, guys. Please. So, why don't you just give Faye a little insight to how it went?
I thought the heat was on for quite a few minutes just because we got slammed with orders, but with the communication with me and Mark, tag-teaming on the grill and just communicating across the board.
One or two plates come back, but when we put it back out, not one complaint.
I have a confession to make. Faye did not go home. She was with you because she was sat behind the restaurant in the car park, watching everything you did, listening to everything you said on a monitor. And I think she has something she'd like to say to you all.
I'm really proud of you all. There is a few mistakes that we can work on. And
what did you think of Brenda's performance?
Amazing. You're amazing. And I feel like I don't tell you enough. It's an eye-opener for me what I saw today, to see how hard you work. And I commend you for taking a charge.
And I did this little exercise for Faye to watch to understand how good you are. And let me tell you something. You clearly passed the test.
You did. Yeah. I was proud
so well
of
done.
You all.
We do have to improve the food, right? Granted, yes?
Yes?
But for me, the relationship was far more important than the food first. Today is a new beginning, okay? Give me 15 minutes, and I'd like to get into the kitchen and start cooking something exciting with the two owners. Well done, all of you.
I'm really excited that Faye got to watch how we run the place. I really do hope Faye starts treating me as a partner and not her niece. It's gone on definitely too long, and we're ready to move forward.
I really hope in the future we can agree about the staff meeting.
Definitely.
And we have to address what's bothering us. I know now we have to work as a team. And I hope that we could move from my obsession with everything being perfect.
We need to act like a team and we need to strive as a team.
And I realize it's about time to treat Brenda as my business partner and not only my niece. You know, I know that we need to fix a lot of things.
We definitely proved it to Faye that we can do our jobs. We are capable of helping her out when she needs, and she just needs to allow us to do it. So we'll see what happens.
You did a good job. I'm proud.
Let's go, you two. What is that?
Fresh fish.
Oh, it's definitely fresh fish. How does it feel?
Awesome.
Here's the thing. Buying fresh, sending that message out to your customers is the only message to go ahead. So I'm going to do two very simple dishes. We'll do a nice yellowtail. We'll do a nice little shrimp kebab.
It's an out-of-this-world experience to be taught by Chef Ramsay.
Find the grill and start to market.
I am learning that when you said fresh, it means really fresh. It doesn't mean it's frozen fresh.
Fresh lemon juice in the rice. Now you can smell the herbs.
It smells
okay, and the lemon
amazing.
In there. From there, my herbs go in, and then I've got a little touch of vegetable stock. Just a touch. Goes
what
on.
Kind of stock?
Vegetable stock. I've poured my heart and soul into this place the last 5 years, and this is the first time I feel like an equal partner with Faye.
I'm just going to show you how we play this up.
If we cook just delicious and fresh, and if Brenda will continue to change her work ethics, be a business owner, I think will make us a very strong team. Amazing.
Something very important you should both know. Yesterday, after my lunch, I went around town, but I asked Just people walking towards me. Tell me about Zaina's Flaming Grill.
Zaina's Flaming Grill. Ever heard of it?
No.
Damn.
Passed through and seen it, never really stopped.
Have you been?
I have not.
Nobody's heard of this place, man.
Over 3/4 of the people I spoke to, they have never heard of Zaina's Flaming Grill. So I've arranged for a small exclusive spot at the Redondo Pier. We're gonna tell Redondo that you're here to stay and we're here to relaunch, okay?
Okay.
And we're gonna take little samplers to get the word out there. And most importantly, I want them leaving with Zaina's Flaming Grill's flavor.
Okay, awesome.
Get all the team together and we're gonna head to the Redondo Pier, okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah? Come over, guys. All right, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling good.
So, we're relaunching tomorrow night.
All right.
Yeah? Zaina's Flaming Grill is now flaming hot. Why don't you and I work behind?
All right.
Yeah, and then you three can market the hell out of the new Zaina's flaming grill. Grill. Yeah? Got it?
Yes.
OK, let's go. Let's go.
You guys hungry?
Come on in.
Yes. Enjoy, guys.
Here we go. Enjoy.
A delicious shrimp kebab with a tzatziki sauce.
Enjoy.
This is definitely what we need right now. People that actually live really close or just a few minutes away have never heard about us.
We're Zaina's Flaming Grill, PCH is having you out.
We're doing a new launch. We'd love to have you in. We're by the beach. We should let the community know that we are here and we're serving the best of the best.
Enjoy.
How's it taste?
Excellent.
It's
really good. Delicious.
Anyone for shrimp? Would you like some?
I love the sauce.
Excellent. We've never done anything like this, so I think this is really big to come out here and come together and be a team.
We'd love to see you guys.
It's a new beginning.
You guys gotta come check us out. Zaina's Flaming Grill is gonna be flaming awesome. It's gonna be awesome. What's going on now is just, it's a whole new Zaina. Everything is just finally falling in place the way it should be. Your motivation, the drive that was lacking is back.
Love you, boo. Thank you.
The flame is back, right?
Oh, yeah.
Flame is back.
Coming up.
How are we doing down there?
It could be Zaina's biggest night ever.
Faye, did you get that?
Faye.
But on a night when success rests in the hands of Brenda and Faye.
Faye has shut down.
It could turn out to be its biggest disaster.
Faye.
With the word out to the community about the changes at Zaina, Chef Ramsay and his team have just 12 hours to turn a Mediterranean restaurant into a beachside hangout.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are we feeling?
Very excited. Good.
Ready to go crazy.
Are you ready for the new Zaina?
Yes.
We all are.
No fainting allowed.
Let us see it.
On the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Welcome to the new Zaina's.
Oh my god!
It looks stunning.
I love it.
Wow.
Oh my god!
Oh, it's so beautiful.
Gone is that dreary cream color. We have given it a fun, beachy vibe.
It is beautiful as they are.
The booths were hideous. We have completely opened this space up, which has given you another 12 seats.
This is a completely different restaurant.
And then we got stalls. We're going to take advantage of that bar.
Amazing.
At the tables, you have these stunning pewter chairs.
Wow.
Beautiful dinner and flatware donated by Oneida. Plates, bowls, knife and forks, you name it, you've got it.
You can't imagine how thankful I am for this.
Amazing, cool pop art.
I love it.
Quirky, colorful, and cool.
Amazing. This is our dream come true.
It is, definitely is. It couldn't be more perfect. It's very hip, very beachy, and we're ready to unite and get this party going.
Thank you so much.
You okay?
I'm very happy.
Oh, okay, you're crying. I thought you were.
Okay. I honestly never dreamed about owning a place like this. My restaurant was really old-fashioned before. Now it's a beautiful place for people to come in after a day at the beach and enjoy a beautiful beach restaurant.
Now that Chef Ramsay has brought the beach vibe to Zaina,
put a line over there.
He reveals the new tasty, fresh menu to the staff.
Oh, wow.
Yummy.
Yummy.
First off, the dips. Roasted red pepper hummus. Not liquid, but a nice textured hummus. Delicious tabbouleh, parsley, scallions, tomatoes, lemon juice, and classic bulgur wheat.
Beautiful.
And then the lamb meatball gyro, serving the pitta, scallions, and tahini as well.
Wow.
shrimp kebab, finished with lemon, and beautifully served with a pita bread. Last night, we cooked together that wonderful yellowtail. Again, salted potatoes, red onions, and we serve, grill the fish, and send. Excited to taste?
Definitely.
Yeah. Have a really good taste, because tonight, we're going to relaunch this stunning Mediterranean grill with a big bang. Jump in.
The hardest part is figuring out where to start.
This is a party in my mouth right now.
Wow. You're going to love this.
If I start liking that, we might run low before the customers get here.
Delicious, good recipe. This new menu is a dream. A little bit of a change makes a big difference.
Mm. We should put these two together. Watch this.
I am ready to launch my restaurant tonight. I have everything I need now to really serve it on the beach. And it will be just a wonderful feeling to have Brenda and I working together as a team.
Hello, welcome to the new and improved
Ladies. Having spread the word in Redondo Beach about the new look and menu at Zaina Flaming Grill,
this looks so good.
The restaurant is fully booked for relaunch.
It looks like the beach.
It does look just cool.
Are you guys ready to order?
I'm gonna go with the grilled local yellowtail, please.
The yellowtail?
The zucchini fritters.
I'm sure you ladies will enjoy everything.
Right, you ready?
We're fired up.
We have the flame back, and I have to show you that tonight.
Okay, have you warned your husband the flame's back?
I told him earlier today, and he thought I was talking about something else. And I'm sorry.
Keep it clean. It's a family restaurant, for goodness sake.
Okay, zucchini fritters, I'll start that.
Good.
I'm starting the two calamaris and the zucchini, okay?
Good, that's it, talk. The more talking, the better, okay?
Okay, Brenda. Crispy calamari and grilled yellowtail and what else?
And shrimp kebab.
For relaunch, Chef Ramsay has set up a new system in the kitchen that has Faye and Brendan working side by side.
Firing up fries.
Beef kebab.
Rice on grill.
And so far, the plan is working.
It's yummy.
It's so good.
Everything was seasoned perfectly.
But as the orders start to fly in...
Two calamaris and a zucchini fritter coming up, okay, Faye?
Faye has stopped communicating.
Are we good on rice? Do we need rice, Faye?
Faye, talk to Brenda.
And that's slowing down the delivery of the food.
Faye, you don't even look at me. You just stop talking.
I'm doing it.
I know, we're talking work at the same time for me, okay?
Okay?
There we are.
Can I please know the status on table 9? Did you hear me?
Faye's so used to having her mindset where she has to do everything.
Faye, come on.
She just needs to understand that it's not just her in the kitchen anymore, that it's her and Brenda.
How far out is table 9?
No answer. I know. What's going next, please, Brenda? Because Faye's turned off.
We got a lamb kebab, medium rare, and the yellowtail. Let me know if you need something, Faye.
She's not even saying anything. She's just turned off.
Faye is just not communicating. And I just truly hope that we can make it through this dinner without totally falling apart.
How are we doing, Faye?
Faye? Faye? Faye?
It's relaunch night at Zaina Flaming Grill. And Chef Ramsay has implemented a two-chef system in the kitchen.
How are we doing down there, Faye?
Where communication is the key.
Faye, did you get that?
But shortly after dinner started, Faye is shut down and is no longer communicating with Brenda.
Brenda, 30 seconds.
Faye has shut down.
She's so used to working on her own, she refuses to talk. So get her up, get her up, okay. Get some. Okay. Just completely flat, okay. Silent and flat.
Right.
Yeah, your partner, don't forget.
Okay.
You're in the driving seat now.
That's
yeah,
right.
Get her going, please.
Okay.
Please.
How are we doing, Faye? Talk to me. Faye doesn't know how to work with a team.
Come on, talk together, yeah? Let's go.
She's used to doing everything by herself.
Tell Brenda what you're doing there.
Okay.
Rice is behind you. Talk to Brenda.
But I am an owner and I am a boss and I need to take control and bring this place back to life. Faye, we just need you to respond. Just because we had a few minutes of downfall, all we do is get right back up and keep going.
Yes. Yes.
Right? We don't dwell on it. We pick up and move on.
Yes.
Table 3.
Crispy calamari and grilled yellowtail and what else?
And shrimp.
Shrimp kebab.
Keep it going, guys.
What do I need for table 9, Faye?
Meatball gyro.
Meatballs are in the oven.
Good news is you're talking. More
Thank
breaking
you.
News.
With Brenda taking control and encouraging Faye, she is responsive again.
The two chicken and the one lamb is ready.
Excellent.
Nice.
Table 8.
Excellent.
And this duo are now pushing out orders at a much faster rate.
I like that zucchini fritter. It's good. Yeah.
It's fantastic. Thank you, you saved me.
We got each other's back. We're a team.
I am very proud of Brenda tonight. She was my backbone, and it was really nice working as a team. I hope you enjoyed everything, ladies.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. The count of three, Zainas.
One, two, three, Zainas!
The flame is back. God bless you all.
First of all, night one, you achieved a lot. It wasn't going to be perfect, but let me tell you, it's pretty good. Feedback from the customers, what was it?
I didn't get one bad complaint.
Great.
I talked to a few of the tables, and they were really happy. They loved the new decor, and they said this is what a beach restaurant should look like.
The look of this restaurant is completely different. Do you know what else is completely different? The way you treat each other.
I am very proud of all of you.
Brenda, you are a natural-born leader. Tonight, you confirmed you're a partner.
Thank you.
Today, she pulled her weight and she held my back up. She's amazing. Chef Ramsay gave me my family back and my restaurant back. I finally have the partner I always wished for. Thank you so much. I really appreciate you so much.
Best of luck.
Chef Ramsay has changed our lives, and I am worried about Faye going back to her old ways.
Well done, my darling. Good job.
But we'll see what happens.
When I first arrived, I didn't think a relaunch of this restaurant was even possible. Brenda and Faye were completely at odds, and the staff behind them, they had no direction. But unbelievably tonight, Brenda and Faye were working side by side in their kitchen. My only hope now is that Faye really understands that she's not in this alone. Wow. Beaten by a store-bought hummus. Unbelievable.
After Chef Ramsay left,
I'm gonna come cross out what I just took out.
Okay, baby.
Zaina became a popular spot in Redondo Beach. But unfortunately,
that chicken is not done.
Faye has taken a step back.
I want to get the chicken because this is the hottest as what in the grill.
It's burning, that's why.
And her stubbornness has resulted in Vanessa and Emel leaving the restaurant.
Whatever.
Meatballs are heating up for table 6.
On the positive side, Brenda has taken on a more active role.
It's almost ready.
Excellent.
And the two owners continue to work on their relationship.
Keep it up. You're doing good.
Thank you.
As well as maintain their newfound success.
We're glad to have you here. We hope to see you again.
Thank you.
Next time on Kitchen Nightmares.
What in the f*** is going on?
Chef Ramsay finds an owner who is completely clueless.
I don't know why we don't have people coming through the door.
As she has no idea why her restaurant is failing.
I'm amazed you've stayed open for 3 years.
The food is hideous.
That's like baby vomit.
And the standards are repulsive.
Oh, you dirty bastards.
Chef Ramsay tries his best.
You have big issues here.
To save a restaurant that might just be impossible to save.
This Monday, witness the return of Jack. 24, Live Another Day is coming on Fox.